And in the sky was angel Jibreel. He said, oh Muhammad, oh Rasulullah. He said, oh Muhammad, Nabi of Allah. He said, oh Muhammad, Prophet of Allah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to our program of Who is Muhammad? May Allah's peace and blessings be upon him. Well, we're moving right along, and we've been discussing these past weeks of who exactly is the Prophet of Allah, the one whom Allah said you are on an exalted standard of character. Well, we're going to continue with that with our Sheikh Abu Suhaib Bassam. But firstly, we're going to discuss his characteristic, or that exalted character that he called all mankind to. My question to you today is this: how do you define the word contentment? How would you define it? Okay, you answer the question. Let's see what some other people had to say, and then we'll come on back here just as we normally do, and we will see what the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to say, and we'll do that right here in the ruins of the desert. So stay with us.
How would I define contentment? I'm not dwelling on what I don't have, what others have and I don't have.
Personally, I'm as contented as long as my family are happy and I feel okay myself, then I'm contented. I've got food on my table and I can put clothes on my back and on my kids' back. It's fine by me. I'm content.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be upon you all. Today is another episode of Who is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Remember that the last time we were talking about the story of a great man that was the rabbi Abdullah ibn Salam, whom he has embraced Islam, and he showed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam how his tribe, how his fellows, the ones who had the same belief, Judaism, they weren't honest, they weren't truthful. Those people, they lied, and they knew that the Prophet ﷺ was the messenger mentioned in their book, but yet they denied the message. At the beginning they said that he is the best of us, and then later on, when he showed them that he is a Muslim, he said he is the worst amongst us. Now this is to do with the people of the Jews. Now let's see and talk about the people of Christians. What do they say as well regarding the Prophet ﷺ? This is another story of a great man whom is called Salman al-Farisi. Salman al-Farisi. Farisi are from Persia, Furs. Salman, he says, I was in a village, I was born in a village, which is called Jay, and it is apart from Asbahan. People of Asbahan, Asbahan is a place in Iran. He says that my father was the governor of that village, and I was brought up to be a very dedicated person, and I was, well, looking after my father. And my father loved me so much. And I was the best, the most beloved person to my father. Even that he loved me so much, he had to lock me in the house. He doesn't want anybody sort of to harm me and so on and so forth. His father had some yard, a land, where he wanted to build some sort of houses on it. So he kept busy himself with it until then he said to me, my son, go, because I'm getting old, go and continue the building onto that yard. So I went to the yard, and remember, it was just almost my first time to leave my house. On the way, I found a church, and I have heard in the church that some people are praying in the church. I liked their praying, so I went inside to see, and I saw them mentioning God, and mentioning prayers, and mentioning chanting there. I liked their prayer. And it was better than the religion of mine. Remember that the religion of the Persians are the Magians. They are Magians, so they are worshippers of the fire. And because he was so dedicated, the people of that village appointed him to be Qatin an-Nar, which means the one who is looking after the fire.
So every time the fire is to be off, he had to let it on again. So he was the qatin, he was the one like the priest. He was a priest, and a major priest. So when he went into the church, he liked the chanting, he liked the prayer. So here, Salman, he stayed with them until dawn, until night, sunset. And then he went back to his father. His father was really worried. He said to him, "My son, I always got used to you are on coming on time, but this time you were a bit late." So he said, "Well, I have passed by a church, my father." He was telling the truth, he doesn't lie. "And I stayed with them and I liked their prayers. And I think I want to be a Christian." He says to him that your religion, the religion of your fathers, is better than this religion. That means worshipping the fire. He says, "Is it not? It is not better than my religion. And I think Christianity is better." So his father now is worried. He said, "And my father now, he put chains in my leg, so I can't leave my house. And I was there. Then I talked to my fellows from the Christians. I said to them, if any business people, merchants, coming by from the Bilad al-Sham, please inform me." Because he knew that Christianity is to search it in the Bilad al-Sham. You remember Bilad al-Sham, the land of al-Sham, which is Lebanon, Syria, Palestine, Jordan, and part of Iraq, the north of Iraq. So he said, if anybody coming from that land, because he wants to travel to the land of Christianity, please inform me. Then some business people arrive from those areas, and they come by. So they inform him while he was in his chains. So he breaks the chain, and he leaves his father, and he goes with those business people, with the merchants. And they take him, all the way to Bilad al-Sham. There he asked, "Who is the best priest amongst you?" They said, "The Asqaf of al-Kanisa, the one who is in that church. He is the priest of that church." So he went to the priest and he told him, "I want to be your student, a devoted student to yours. I want to serve you, to look after the church. Can you let me to do so?" He said, "No problem." So he keeps his company. But he knew and he realized later on, he came to know that this person, this priest, or so-called priest, is a person who is a liar. People from the Christians, they used to bring charity to him. He used to take the charity, keeps it for himself. And he hides it in a jar until he had many jars full of gold. Many jars full of gold. He used to hide them. Then when this man died, the Christians, they took him to the burial procession, sort of looking at him with reverence and so on and so forth. He said, "Verily, this man is a thief. I knew him and I saw him. Every time you give him charity, he doesn't give it to the right people. He keeps it for himself." They said to him, "What is your proof?" He says, "Well, I will tell you where he used to hide his jars." So he pointed to them, to the place where he buried his jars. So they went there and they dug the jars out. And they were full of gold. They found 7 jars. Because of that, what they did, they crucified him. While he's dead. And they started stoning that so-called priest. But Salman al-Farisi still is after the truth. So he asked for the best of people after that. And they told him that after they appointed a new man to that church, he kept as well with that man in the same church. Subhanallah, that man was so different from the first one. This man is so honest. This man, he was dedicated to his prayer. Prays 5 times a day. So this man is so modest. This man is charitable man. He gives the charity to the poor people. He loved him so much. He knew that this person, he is true person, representing the true faith. But because the man has to die, he's getting old, this priest, this new priest. So Salman al-Farisi approached him before his death. He said, "Please, appoint somebody for me. Tell me about another person who is like you. I loved you so much and I served you. And I think you are the best. And I want to be with somebody just like you. Do you know anybody? Do you recommend someone?" He said, "Yes. Well, there is only one man whom I know who is just like me. Or maybe better. That is a person in Al-Musul. A person who is a priest in Al-Musul. Go to that area and you'll find him." So Salman al-Farisi, he made the trip and went after the death of his master, after the death of his priest, all the way to Al-Musul to meet that man. And he stayed with him. And he actually was the same as his first or the previous priest. He was so dedicated to his religion. He loved him so much. And that person came to death again. He wants to die. He's about to die. So he talks to, now Salman al-Farisi is talking to him. He says to him, I loved you so much. Please recommend me another man. So he recommends him another man. He says, the only person which I think that he is like me and the previous ones, that is the one in a place called Al-Juburiyya. And he went to that place, which is called Al-Juburiyya, to find that priest, to find that man. And he found him. That is, not Juburiyya, sorry, it is the Amuriyya. The place, Amuriyya, had the man and he met him. And he stays with that man. Salman al-Farisi now is with that man. He loved him so much. And he thinks that he is the man. But suddenly again this man, he gets ill and he gets sick. And he's about to die. So Salman al-Farisi again asks him, please recommend me a man. So he says to him, there is no men left which are like us. But there is something. Keep tuned and inshallah you'll find out in the second part of this episode. Jazakumullah khairan.
Whatever makes you contentment. Contentment is everybody's own, everybody holds their own secret to their contentment. What makes you happy probably doesn't make me at all happy. What makes me happy probably bores the hell out of you. So is that in yourself? You've got to search for that in yourself then.
Just generally, you know, being happy with yourself and having good friends around you, good family, that kind of thing, I suppose.
Content. Contentment. Waking up in the morning with a smile on your face. Every day. As best I can. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam. Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman. خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه ورتل القرآن ترتيلا. Learning how to recite the Quran properly. Learning the meaning of what we recite. Concluding the ahkam from the verses which we recite. Trying to implement what we learn in our daily life. We'll listen to the participants and the guests. We'll take your phone calls. We're going to recite live. We'll listen to your recitation. And we'll correct it according to the rules and regulations which we'll state in each episode. Now, your dream will come true.
محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Peace be upon you all. Remember, we are still in the story of Salman al-Farisi. It's a very great story. And inshallah, I would like to finish the story. And maybe it will take us the whole part of this second part. And maybe inshallah we'll have time to as well do the characteristic. Here Salman al-Farisi, after searching for the truth, remember that he was a fire worshipper. Then after that he became a Christian. Then traveling from one priest to another, and he was with four priests. The fifth one, the first one, he was a bad man. But the other four were the best. And they were good people. They were dedicated to their religion. The last one was in a place called Amuriyya. Then when he's about to die, Salman al-Farisi asked him, can you recommend me someone just like the previous ones? He said, there is nobody left. But you are in a time where there's a prophet. The prophet is about to come, or maybe he came already. Now, seek him in a land where it is between palm trees. Because this is written in their books, in their Torah. They knew that, in their Bible, in their gospel. They know that. So they said, seek him into the land where there's palm trees. So for those Christians who died, dedicated to their religions, they are Muslims. They are the ones who are like Islam. But because they did not see the Prophet of Allah, if they had seen him, they would have believed in him. Because the last one he said, you are now in a time of a prophet. You have to follow him. You have to be one of his people. So here Salman, radiallahu anhu, is listening to his master, to his priest, telling him, where to seek that prophet. So he said to him, search him in the land where it is between two harra as well. And it's the land where there's palm trees. And his signs are follows, that he does not accept charity, but he does accept the gift. He will eat from the charity, but he will not eat. So he will not eat from the charity, but he will eat the gift. Then he said to him, there's a seal at the back of his shoulder, the seal of prophethood. So Salman al-Farisi, after the death of his priest, the last one, he starts making some money. So he buys some cows and some sheep. And he was wishing for someone who could take him to the land of the Arabs. Because his priest, he said to him, it is in the land of the Arabs. Because that, those land or the palm trees, is in the land of the Arabs. You don't find palm trees in the Bilad al-Sham. So he went to the land of the Arabs, the Arabian Peninsula, with those merchants. He asked them, if I have offered you my cows and my sheep, would you take me all the way there? They said, no problem. So they took him. And there he is. But those people were traitors. Those merchants, business people, they were traitors. They sold him to a Jew man. So Salman here became a slave. But when the Jew man took him, he took him to a land where there's so many palm trees. So he knew that he was very close from that land. So alhamdulillah. And I think those Jews that who bought this Salman al-Farisi, that Jew man who bought Salman al-Farisi, he lives on the outskirts of Medina, not far away from that place. And he was serving his master. Remember that he became a slave now. Now, the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent by the revelation. In Mecca, he didn't hear about the Prophet of Allah. Salman al-Farisi didn't hear any news regarding the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was in Mecca. But when he migrated to the Medina, he says that while I was on top of one of the palm trees, trying to get some dates for my master, a cousin of my master came and approached him. And he started talking to him and I'm listening. He said, verily, may Allah fight the tribe of Qila. Because they are in Quba at the moment, waiting for a man. They say that he is a prophet coming. As soon as I heard that, just like something came to me, I was shivering. And I almost fell on top of the head of my master from the palm tree. And straight away I went down, climbing down, straight away. I told his uncle, what are you saying? What are you talking? Is a prophet? So my master, when he saw this, he just punched me in my eye. I fell on the ground. And he said to him, don't pay attention to him. And after that, when I woke up, he said to me, go back to your work. Why are you concerned with this? SubhanAllah. Why is he concerned with this? You know, because he was searching for the truth all of his life. Since he was, or before he reached even his puberty. Before he became an adult. Now, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was in Quba, when he arrived, Salman al-Farisi, now he collects something and he wants to take it to Quba to meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He went to Quba and he met the Messenger of Allah. And then he gave him this and he said to him, I have heard that you are and your companions, the ones who migrated, needs this food. So I'm giving it to you as a charity. So the Prophet ﷺ, he takes it and he tells his companions to eat from it, but him, he did not eat anything. So Salman, he said, this is one. One sign has been fulfilled. Prophet of Allah did not eat from the charity, but he let his companions to eat from it. Then Salman al-Farisi on the next day, or some sort of sometimes later on, he comes and he collects something, but the Prophet of Allah now is not in Quba, he's in Al-Madinah. And inshallah, we'll continue the story in the next part of this episode.
It's just about being humble. And just being, it's about being humble, you know, and being grateful for what you are given. Because we live in a society where we just want what we want. But when you look at the third world, how they're living, it's much more hard. They will love to have the opportunity that we have. And we waste what we have over here. So it's about being humble and about being grateful for what we do have here.
I would define that as being at peace with yourself and with people around you. I would also define it as having a purpose as well, because I think it's all very well being at peace, but if you don't actually have a purpose that you feel like you're working towards, then I'm not sure how contented you can be.
Contentment is happiness in a frame of mind, in that it's relative. It's relative to security and fear and desire.
I know, just happy day to day, doing things you like to do, hanging out with people you like to hang out with.
To be satisfied with as little as possible.
Contentment. Contentment is being at one with yourself and being at one with other people. Finding your place within the world, I'd say.
Waking up in the morning with a smile on your face. Every day. As best I can. That's it.
Welcome back. All right, now. Have you taken your trip to the refrigerator, got yourself something to drink? That's good, because we don't want you to go anywhere right now, because we're getting ready to get into the topic of the characteristics. We've discussed the sira for today. Now we're going to move on to the other topic. Now, question still stands. How do you define contentment? Got it? Good. Let's go back to the Sheikh and see what he had to say from the Messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
And inshallah, now we will talk about another characteristic of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, where he had emphasized for the Muslim to embrace. And that is taken from the following hadith, which is, لَيْسَ الْغَنِيِّ عَنْ كَثْرَةِ الْعَرَضِ. Riches is not having many belongings. وَلَكِنَّ الْغِنَى غِنَى النَّفْسِ. But richness is the richness of the soul. Contentment. Person having the richness of the soul. This is the proper richness. In this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling the Muslim is to be satisfied and contented. That means is not to be greedy and after the world, after the wealth and after the money. Because you remember, you find a lot of people who have a lot of money, but they're wicked people. They have no good characteristics. They have no good character themselves. But you find the person who is poor, but yet is self-satisfied. He feels he's in the top of the world because of his iman. So the person here humbles himself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Humbles his heart to Allah azza wa jal. He finds himself, there is no need for him to be running and chasing behind the world. Chasing after possessions and properties. He wants to chase after satisfying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fulfilling his obligation towards his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is being the richness of the soul. The person, when he is like this, people will start loving. Even though that I would say some of the people are after the rich people because they want them, for example, to marry their daughters. But I would say the proper person, he would not look for those people. He would look for a person who is satisfying his Lord. And he doesn't look how much money he has got. And that is why we say to you, brothers and sisters, it's very important that the person is all the time attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Attached with his heart to what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to him. Not to possessions. Because if it's so, then we will see him, he will be reluctant, for example, to fulfill his obligation. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had to say to us to make the jihad, you find that person who is not self-satisfied, feeling that he has to be concerned about his dunya. He will be clinging heavily to earth. He will not leave all these possessions and all these property for sacrificing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Self-contentment, self-richness, to be rich in the soul, not to be rich in the money. That's the characteristic that we need to emphasize, and that is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam needs from us. Inshallah, in the next episode, we will be talking about the continuation of the story of Salman al-Farisi. And after that, inshallah, we will be talking about another characteristic. And as well, of course, we will be talking about the migration of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Remember, we didn't talk about him going from Quba to Medina. For that, keep tuned. Jazakumullahu khayran. For the next time, wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
And in the sky was Angel Jibreel. He said, O Muhammad, O Rasulullah.
He said, O Muhammad, Nabi of Allah. He said, O Muhammad, Prophet of Allah.